You're probably super familiar with the query store for SQL Server, but did you know that Azure Database for Postgres also has a query store that you can turn on? Learn all about it and how to get started this week on Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined by Grant Fritchey. Grant, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Sure. So my name's Grant Fritchey. I work for Redgate Software. I'm an advocate for the company, which means I get to fly around the world teaching people about IT stuff, which is a lot of fun. I'm a Microsoft Data Platform MVP, and I spend a lot of time in SQL Server and Postgres.
Awesome. Cool. Well, we're excited to have you on the show. Great member of the community. So also great working with you as always. But today we're going to be talking about something I don't know anything about. And that is a query store for Postgres. And yeah, everybody heard that right. So Grant, tell us what is this query store for Postgres and what do we need to know and how do we get started?
Yeah, well, heck yeah. Look, I'm a huge fan of Query Store in SQL Server. So the day I saw that they were working on this thing called Query Store for Postgres, I got really jazzed because it solves a really common problem. So like in Postgres, you've got PG stats, right? PG stats statements, which will get you query information, and it's good data. It will help you understand what's happening on your systems so you can troubleshoot, you can do performance tuning and all that good stuff. But there is an issue with it. And that issue is the same in SQL Server and the DMVs, and that's that it's an aggregation. And because it's an aggregation, you can't get two points of data to compare, meaning before and after I added an index, before and after I you know, cleaned up the statistics, before and after we made a change to the code in a function. You know, you don't have that before and after because it's just cumulative. So you can't see changes over time. Query store, while it does store information in an aggregate fashion, it breaks the aggregations down by default to 1 hour segments, giving you before and after. Now, it's not detailed. If you need detailed, you're going to have to look at it another way. But if you need to know yesterday to today, 2 hours ago to now, all that kind of stuff, you've got it. And that's the beauty of it, really. And it's awesome. Lightweight and all kinds of other cool stuff.
Cool. I mean, it sounds great. It sounds like as a SQL person, like, why wouldn't you want this? So
yeah.
Are there limitations or is it something that's only available in Azure Database for Postgres? Is there a specific extension? Like, how do I get it?
It is an extension inside of Azure. So it is only for Azure Database for Postgres. That's where you get it. And it's unique to the Azure platform. And it's just fantastic. I can show you if you want to see it.
Yeah, let's take a look.
Cool. Well, I mean, right here on the screen, the first thing I've got is I went ahead and brought up the portal and I did a quick little search inside the portal for the server settings. So you've got a whole bunch of controls that you can do on that PG query store, and it'll allow you to, you know, look for different plan sizes, varying query length, how you want to do the capture mode. So you can turn it all, just get in the top queries. You can even say no queries at all if you want to. You can control it all the way, but then it gets fun. Here, let's switch over to Azure Data Studio. So if you look inside of Azure, there's an Azure system database inside of the Postgres instance. And inside there is Query Store. And inside Query Store, we can see all the fun things it can collect. Query plans, text, the runtime stats, which is what we all care about. The intervals, you know, the breakdown of, remember I said it aggregates by hour. You can get all that information. And then there's views on all of it too. So you guys, Microsoft has supplied all these different views for pulling the information out. And then there's even some functions for resetting it and doing other things with it. But here, let's just get started with queries. That's the easy way to do it. So I've been running some code in the background, nothing crazy, but I've got some stuff. So we will actually see results come in, and you can see that there's, all these different queries, and they've been called a number of times, and you can get a lot of information out of it. So I mean, it's useful. And we can look at the stats too, because we've got query stats, PGM stats, and we could take a look at that. And it breaks it down. And now you see query counts and all those fun things. Most of them are zero right now because my system's been sitting idle. It's just a demo system. Let's see if we can get to the end now. Okay. But then it gets fun. So what we can do is we can take advantage of the views. Let me just let's make it so we can see this just a little bit better. There we go. So we're going to go to the query store view. I'm going to go for my database ID. So it's a particular database I'm running. It's my own little database, Hamshack radio for storing radio information. I've got a start time put in, and I've got a user ID. That's my user ID. And so now what I can do is I can say, okay, well, give me the text, start and end time, how many calls, the total time, the total number of rows, and then the query ID. So I pull these together and we run this. And then we get some fun stuff. And so you can see just the queries running on my system, just the queries that are calling. And so, like, I've got one query here that's been called, what was
Wow.
that, 5 million times? Yeah, this is the one I put it on a loop and just let it keep running and running. And so you can see that it's been running all this time, all these various times over and over again. And it gives us that ability to start understanding what's going on with our systems because you can see the total time, the number of rows processed, everything I need to see to be able to process this thing, I've now got. So it makes a huge difference. But it gets better. So it's not just queries and query runtime, which is cool, but it's also wait statistics. So again, pass it in, go for the same user ID, go for the same database ID. And now we've got wait stats as well. So what are my queries waiting on? That gives me the ability to then, make determinations as, am I on the wrong tier of Azure? Do I need to go up a tier? Maybe even down a tier? Do I need to, look at some changes to my configurations? All that good stuff. It's all right inside there. But there's more. What about explain plans? What if I went in there and said, hey, you know what? I want to look at the explain plan. By the way, for those who don't know, explain plans are same thing as execution plans in SQL Server. Simple enough. And it returns me the full explain plan. So I can see exactly what's going on inside that query and oops, wrong button, and how the optimizer chose to do it. So with that, I've got everything I need to see, that it's doing an index scan, it's got a condition, it's doing, less nested loops joins between the index scans,
Nice.
and all that information is all right there. So it's completely laid out. So the other thing I like to do is show this other query. Now this query, what I'm doing, it's a function called longer query, and I'm bringing in two date time, compare time and base time. Cool, easy enough to understand. It's going to return a table. Returns a float, mean, standard deviation, which I think is just so important. It's good to know your averages, but you need to know the standard deviation so you have an idea of whether or not that average is a very wide average or a very narrow average. So then the explain plan, the database ID, and all that stuff. I'm using subqueries to pull it together. I'm joining those two subqueries together and then bringing it all back in one query to find anything that's got a place where the max time changed. So I can find the queries that ran longer. I can literally look at
Oh.
the queries and figure out what's going on. Now, that's how that works. It's really cool. But let me switch back over to here for one second, over to the portal. There we go. So one of the other things that comes up though is if you're using Query Store, Microsoft is giving us some new functionality that's dependent on the Query Store being there to collect data. Now, I'm not going to get into a demo on it because it's a bit more involved, but it can actually help me set a more appropriate auto vacuum for Postgres. And what that means is I can get better statistics inside my Postgres database, meaning better performance, better plans, and you know all those things. But Microsoft is making it so I will get that information better. Also, by adding it in, we can take a look at Query Performance Insight, which, again, I'm not getting into the demo on that yet because it, you know, we've only got a couple minutes. And so there's a whole bunch there, too. And that's all dependent on having the query store run. So it's a big deal. I love it. It's making a big change in the kind of information I can show people on performance inside of their PostgreSQL databases.
Awesome. This is amazing. Grant, I see a lot of value here. I love how you showed it to us, showed us how easy it is to get started with it. Any final tips or tricks for folks who are maybe just getting started with Azure Database for Postgres and the Query Store?
No, not really. The one thing I would say is that not every single load is going to play well with this. So make sure you do some testing to bring it on. It's extremely lightweight. It's extremely safe. Microsoft's done a fantastic job, but testing is still your friend. That's the one thing I would always say. But other than that, no, it's really easy to get in. It's literally a switch. You flip it on. You don't restart your database or anything. It starts collecting data. You can make determinations on how you want to collect that data, but other than that, it's just off and running.
Awesome. Cool. Well, Grant, thanks so much for coming on the show. Personally, I learned a lot. I'm sure our viewers learned a lot as well. Viewers, if you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like. Leave us a note to let us know what you think of the Query Store in Azure Database for Postgres. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.